Hello, DigiFam! Welcome again sa channel natin. And today, pag-usapan natin ang another tool na pwede natin idagdag sa arsenal natin as freelancers or online workers. So, na-try nyo na bang mag-send ng email and makareceive ng bounce notification? Bounce meaning yung sinend nating email, hindi nakarating sa recipient and bumalik sa atin. So, if it's a personal email, medyo hassle, of course, pero okay lang siya as long as hindi urgent yung sinend nating email and hindi siya matter of life and death, ba? Pero may iba sa atin na ang email marketing, ang niche, so ibig sabihin nakasalalay sa deliverability ng emails yung work natin. So, either you own the email marketing business or virtual assistant ka and ang pinapagawa sa'yo ng client mo is to send marketing emails to a group of people. So, syempre, the more people na makaka-receive ng email, better. So, getting bounced email is not just a simple hassle sa mga ganong situation. Getting bounced email can actually ruin your IP address's sender reputation. So, ano ba ang sender reputation? So, ang sender reputation tells other parties whether it's safe to receive emails coming from your or IP address. So every time nagbabounce yung mga emails mo, may impact yun sa sender reputation mo. Pag umabot ka ng mga around 20% bounce rate, pwedeng isuspend ng ESP or email service provider yung email account mo. And at the same time, syempre, yung mga ibang organization, mag-flag na yung email address mo. If you try to send them an email, hindi na yun makakarating. And then again, it's going to be counted as a bounced email. Okay, so bakit nga ba nagbabounce ang mga emails? So may two types of bounce emails. So number one, we have what we call the soft bounce. So usually this happens kung ang sinasenda natin, puno na yung inbox niya. So ibig sabihin, hindi na makareceive ng bagong emails. Right? Pero temporary lang to. So the second type of bounce email naman is what we call the hard bounce. Mga common reasons dito includes invalid email addresses or hindi existent yung email address or nakablock na yung email mo from the recipient's end. So anytime na magsisend ka sa kanila ng emails, hindi na makakarating or since block na nga yung address mo. Another thing to watch out for kapag nagsisend ng emails ay ang mga spam traps. So ano nga ba ang mga spam traps? So yung mga spam traps, it's actually good for those who want to prevent spams. It's a spam prevention method na ginagawa ng mga ISPs or internet service providers kung saan gumagawa sila ng mga valid looking email addresses. So mukha talaga silang totoo. Pero in reality, it's not. So walang may-ari ng mga spam traps addresses. And kapag nag-send ka ng email sa isa sa mga yun, hindi naman sila syempre nag-opt-in, automatic flag ka na as a spam. So, ano ulit ang mangyayari kapag nag-flag ang email address mo as a spammer? So again, it will negatively impact your sender reputation. So hindi lang basta negatively impact this time. It's actually very dangerous sa sender reputation mo. So usually ang ginagawa ng mga ISPs, gumagawa sila ng mga fake email addresses na publicly available sa mga forums or blogs para yung mga web scrapers makukuha yung mga email addresses na yun. And of course, kapag nasend mo ng emails yung mga addresses na yun, automatic ibablock ka na ng ISP mismo. Kasi nga, for you to be able to get those spam trap addresses na wala naman talagang may-ari is, well, you're doing something unacceptable, like collecting email addresses without the owner's permission. So to prevent those from happening, we have email validation tools. And isa nga sa mga top email validation tools, which I recommend, is Zero Bounce. So ano nga ba ang Zero Bounce? Tara, punta tayo sa website nila. Okay, so para makapunta sa Zero Bounce, type lang natin yung zerobounce.net. So take note, hindi siya .com, it's .net. And dadalhin tayo dito sa website na to. Okay, so you can either log in if you already have an existing account, and of course, you can sign up for free. So check natin yung pricing niya. So available siya for free, pero you can only send up to 100 or you can only do up to 100 email validations. And you can also see the prices here. So this is pay as you go, by the way. So ibig sabihin, every time that you need to validate email, you need to have credits. And you can see here the amount or how much it costs, depends on the number of credits. So for example, you need to get 2,000 credits. Sabihin, you need to validate 2,000 email addresses. Then you need to pay 0.08 $5. So this is pay as you go. So the more force, the more credits that you need for validating the email, so the more expensive it will be. Or you can also go monthly. Here, click ko lang to, and you can see how much it will be. For example, you need 2,000 email validation credits per month. That's going to be $0.0075. Pero anyway, so you can try it for free, as I've said, and you have 100 email validation credits. So, you know, just give it a try so you can check how effective Zero Bounce is. But I have an existing account, so let me just try to sign in. Okay, so once you log in, ito yung makikita natin sa loob, and you can even see here how many credits you have left. So for this account, I have remaining 806 credits. So I can still validate up to 806 email addresses. Tapos check natin kung ano yung mga available or mga valid na files that you can use. So madali lang siyang gamitin. All you have to do is here, sa part na to, you just select the file, you upload the file ng mga email addresses that you want to validate. Pero check muna natin kung ano yung mga acceptable file formats. So here, meron tayong link dito. So when you click on this, tell us kung ano yung mga acceptable file formats. And so mga allowed file formats, so tumatanggap siya ng .txt, .csv, .xls, or .xlsx. So ito for those who are using notepads, CSV, and then if you're using Excel, so those are all acceptable. And then may mga sample file format siya. So just the email addresses is enough. So this is an example. If you're using a notepad, pwede siyang, di ba, sunod-sunod lang as long as separated siya by commas. Ito yung mga email addresses niya. Or you can even do it this way. So hindi na need ang comma, basta different line siya, separate lines. And this is another example. So you have the first name and then you have the email address. This is also okay. And then sa CSV naman, so this is an example. So you have the first column showing the email addresses, you have the first name and then the last name. Or as I've mentioned, ang importante lang naman talaga is the email address. We have the email address here, and that's it. So those are the acceptable file formats. So try natin mag-upload ng file. I already have a file here with email addresses. So upload it. Then you can see if it's ready. Kapag may green light na dito. So ibig sabihin, it's available na for validation. So kapag syempre, kapag mas madaming email addresses, let's say it's in the thousands, so it might take a while. So wait lang kayo na maging green na yung light bulb dito. And then when it's green, you can click on validate file. And tapos, you need to make sure na nagmamatch yung mga columns niya. So since yung in-upload kong CSV file has multiple columns, so i-check ng Zero Bounce kung ano ba yung mga columns na yun. So we have to make sure na may check dito. Is row 1 the header row? So check natin mismo yung file. Okay, so this is the actual file. And yung first row niya, as you can see here, is a header row. Diba? Hindi siya mga email addresses. So these are the titles or the headers. So kapag ganito yung file na i-upload nyo, so there is an option here, a checkbox that says, is row 1 a header row? So we have to put a check dito sa yes. Otherwise, makakount niya yung first row as an email address row as well. And syempre, magiging invalid. Isa sa mga yon, which is, of course, expected kasi hindi naman talaga siya email addresses. Yeah, so imagine lang natin. So the first row, check natin ah. So row number, so we have email. Tama naman siya. So these are all email addresses. Date, so tama siya. First name, and then last name. Okay, so pag tama na siya lahat, all you have to do is click on process file. If you have less than the number of, if you have less credits than the number of emails that you need to validate, you can just simply click this button over here to buy more credits. But since I only have 50 email addresses here and I have more than enough, so I can just go ahead and click on process file. And so it's already validating the files. It's already validating the email addresses. So all we have to do is wait. So hintayin lang natin dito sa status na nagsasabi na siya ng complete. So as you can see here, it says processing 0%. And you can see here the total number of email addresses. So hintayin lang natin siya. And then after a couple of minutes, probably, so we can refresh and then check again, it's already complete.
Okay.
So after around 2 minutes, the status says complete. And we can already download yung file na validated na. Then we can see here yung breakdown ng mga email addresses. So we can see that 43 out of the 50 are valid email addresses. So that's 86%. We have 4 that are invalid. We have 1 that's catch all, 0 spam traps, 2 abuse, 0 do not mail, and then 0 unknown. So we can actually click this file name niya lang natin or click lang natin siya. Okay, you have selected the file, 50 email addresses. Select the columns you want to be appended in your results. So check lang natin kung ano yung mga gusto natin may sama, right? So okay na yan. So wala na tayong papalitan. Just click on download file. So magda-download siya ng isang zip file. Tayo lang natin siyang matapos. Okay, so once matapos na siya mag-download, so these are all the files inside the zip file. So nakikita natin dito yung iba't ibang klase ng mga results. So nandun pa rin yung original file name natin, which is the 50 email addresses, pero nilagyan niya ng identifier. For example, this is what we want, yung mga valid, pero nakalagay din dito yung unknown, spam traps, overview, original, and so on, right? So when you click on this, may nakalagay ng valid. So 50 email addresses underscore valid. So you can see here, these are all the email addresses that are considered valid, right? So you can see here yung kanyang mga accounts. Yung email niya, by the way, nakalagay lang dito kung ano yung domain, yung account name, and so on. It's even going to identify kung ano yung gender ng mga email addresses na yun based on their first and last name. And so, tapos nakalagay din dito kung ano siyang provider, right? So from Google ba siya or what, or Yahoo. So all those information are already available. Tapos may nakalagay din sa kanya. So let's go back to the zip file. So meron siyang catch all. So ito yung catch all. Kanina, di ba, may nakalagay na isa. So let's try to open kung anong email address to. For example, if you just want to find out, this is an example of a catch all. So later on, we'll check anong definition nito. Then we have the invalid email addresses. Ito yung mga invalid. So according kanina dun sa data, we have 4. So these are the 4 invalid email addresses. So the reason why they are considered invalid are these. So failed syntax, mailbox not found, mailbox not found, and then failed syntax. If you want to see the data, yung breakdown ng mga percentages of those email addresses, so we have this PDF file over here. So let's open this. Okay, so ipapakita dito kung ano yung mga top domains. So from the 50 email addresses na binalidate natin, 23 are from Gmail, we have 8 from Yahoo, and so on. So we can see here the validation results. We have 43 valid. That's the orange portion here ng pie graph, then 4 invalid, and so on. And so ganyan lang kabilis gamitin. Okay, and if you're asking kung ano yung ibig sabihin ng iba't ibang mga statuses na yon, so we have here another link that says status code. So let's actually go here. And so we have here the deliverability status explanation, valid of course. These are the emails na kailangan natin to be able to send the emails successfully. We have the invalid, right? So these are the emails that we determined to be invalid. So please delete from your mailing list. 99.99% accurate. So do you mga possible reason niya, typo, mailbox not found, no DNS entries, mailbox quota exceeded, routable IP address. Then we have the catch-all. So remember from the results kanina, meron tayong isang catch-all. These emails are impossible to validate without sending a real email and waiting for a bounce. The term catch-all means the email server tells you that the email is valid, whether it's valid or invalid. If you want to email these addresses, I suggest you segment them into a catch-all group and know that some of these will most likely bounce. So, hindi siya guaranteed whether it's a valid or invalid email. Then we have the spam trap. Ito yung pinag-usapan natin kanina. So they should not be mailed. So yung mga nakalagay sa spam traps, whenever you get results na may spam trap doon, so remove them, right? Delete them. Do not ever send emails to those email addresses. Then we have the abuse. These emails are of people who are known to click the abuse links in emails, hence abusers or complainers. So we recommend not emailing this these addresses as well. Then of course we have the do not mail, we have the unknown, right? So yeah, just read this. So napaka useful nitong file na to, right? But for our purposes, so we just want to get all the valid email addresses. And so ganyan lang kadaling gamitin yung zero bounce. So that's why I mentioned that it's really recommended if you want to make sure that all your emails are being sent successfully to the recipients. Yeah, so that's it for our video today. Hope you find it helpful. And if you do, please give us a like and subscribe. Thanks. See you again.